So yesterday, the grip and grins, the announcements, they were all there with China's number two. What do you make of them? And will China stick to the plan?
Look, China will stick to its own plan. It really doesn't care what Australia thinks. This is all part of a pantomime, diplomacy. But at the same time, as they're pretending that they want to be our friends, they're trying to buy, bribe and coerce our Pacific neighbours. They're passing laws that say they can arrest anyone in their territory in the South
China Sea. And that's a good point to make, that one right there. That started on the weekend. So any foreigner who they see in their waters, they claim the disputed territory is their waters, they'll arrest. So how does that fit in with, you know, communication systems with our military?
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, look, you just got to work on the basis that China will do what they want, irrespective of what they say. Don't listen to their words. Watch their actions. Mm. Their actions continue to be aggressive. They continue to be territorially ambitious. They tell lies openly about their intentions. And as long as you understand that, you're able to deal with them. And I think the Prime Minister has stuck the right tone.
You know, so how do you deal with that, like, politically, when you know, like, a leader that you're trying to deal with is lying to your face? How do you...
Look, I'm not a diplomat. You know, people often, you know, say, look, let's, you know, Steve could be, you know, an ambassador somewhere. I'm not a diplomat. Yeah. You've just got to be honest in your own assessments about it. And you've got to be honest with the Australian people. And the Prime Minister was. He said, no, we're not setting aside our differences. We have legitimate differences. That doesn't mean you have to pretend you're some hairy-chested strong man like Tony Abbott did. You know, I'm going to shirt front Vladimir Putin. Yeah, that really stopped him invading Ukraine. Well done, you know. So you have to have the ability to walk and chew gum. And with this government, Penny Wong, you can walk and chew gum.
And that was some of their officials, you know, running defence against a poor old Chung Lei yesterday.
Look, the most important thing you've got to understand is that China will treat people the way they treat their own citizens. And this is a sort of thuggish intimidation they engage with, not just in Australia, but all across the world. Remember, they'd set these pseudo-police stations up all across the world that allowed them to drive around and intimidate their diaspora. So this is just normal Chinese behaviour. Don't believe the pandas. Don't believe the, you know, just because they've decided it's in their interest to let our wine or our lobsters back in. They're not doing it because it's in our interest. They've worked out the equation that it's in their interests. Mm. So always expect China to act in its own interests, even if it looks like they're being nice to us.
Yeah. Aren't we paying for the pandas anyway?
Look, I'm not sure.
It's not like they're giving them to us. I thought we have to pay them.
Look,
we kind of rent them. I think it's a big price. I might be wrong, but I might have to check that. But anyway. Hey, good to see you, Stephen.